Thank you, Erwin, for making this happen. Thank you, Maria, for putting it together. And Anne-Marie and Peter, and everybody who's been working hard to set up this meeting, it's deeply appreciated by all of us, I think, and certainly was us from Scandinavia. So what we've learned, and what I've learned from many conversations with Erwin, and what science is now finally coming to acknowledge, what the ancient wisdom keepers have been telling us, that the conscious mind has a larger impact on reality than most of us were aware of. And this quantum physical concept is now beginning to be acknowledged by mainstream science. And we've arrived at a critical choice point now. We are kind of at a junction where we can choose one mindset or another mindset. And what we see happening now is a shift towards a mindset based on fear. It's like taking a step back when you are met with challenges and say, I have to defend myself, I have to defend my family, I have to build up a fence and protect myself. And if I need to use arms to do so, that's one trend of based on fear. And then there's the other trend based on the opposite, which is love. Love and courage and the impulse to connect, to communicate, to co-create on a whole new level. And I'm so happy to be part of this small, still small group of dedicated people who are following that impulse. When I compare what's happening now with what was happening when we met 2 years ago with the sort of on the radical to turn the Club of Budapest into a do-tank instead of a think tank, that was a very uplifting time to sort of be together around that thought. Between then and now, an amazing breakthrough has happened. I mean, I wouldn't even have thought that it would be possible to get 193 heads of state to sign a vision, you know, that they believe in a vision for a new civilization on planet Earth. This is an amazing breakthrough. And what I think we need to do, and I'm building on Ferenc's very inspiring talk here, is to shift our minds and focus on the positive possibilities. Because otherwise we may become overwhelmed by fear and how can we do this? But there's now a roadmap, there's a plan, there's 17 goals, 169 targets, and the intention is to implement them within the next 15 years. So there's also a deadline and a timeline here. The big, big question is how can we make it happen? How can we go from the vision to the actual reality? And I think we need a stepping stone. I think we need to really use the new media technology that we have available now. That's the good news. The good news is that we have the technology available now to communicate across the planet. We have a new generation growing up who are digital natives and completely effortlessly playing with all of these tools and communicating with each other. And this is an amazing opportunity if we use it wisely. It can also be used to evoke more fear and more defensive actions, but I truly believe that the key to our success lies in this new tool which is available now. It wasn't when you signed the Manifesto and put this wonderful vision paper together, you didn't have access to these tools yet. The internet was starting to evolve, but now it's like almost like a global brain waking up and allowing all of us as small imaginal cells to connect with each other and start to think bigger thoughts. And the importance of creating positive thinking now is so, I mean, I can't stop underlining how important it is to communicate. And I think we should say there's 17 goals, but the 18th is missing. The 18th should be about information, about communication, connection, and collaboration, so that we can start to implement the goals from a whole systems perspective. And if we come together, we're all of us more or less representing other organizations, initiatives, projects. And if we can come together and give the best of what we have to share, instead of thinking too much about what's in it for me, how do I promote my own project or my own idea, to really say, let's try and put everything into a circle here and see how, if we can co-create something that's more brilliant than any of us as individuals or individual organizations might be able to put together, then it would be like the manifesto says, like a symphony orchestra with a lot of beautiful, beautiful instruments that have their own individual shape and sound and place in the bigger symphony orchestra, but together we can create a symphony much more beautiful than any individual performance would allow us to do. So that's my entry point to becoming involved in this work. And we have now set up, or in the process of setting up, Club of Budapest in Scandinavia, and we want to reach out from there to all the other national clubs to see what can we build together, inspired by the beautiful vision that Erwin and His Holiness the Dalai Lama were creating back then 20 years ago. I have read it very carefully, and I can completely endorse every word in there. So this is more than just a manifesto. It's actually maybe a blueprint or a roadmap for how we can proceed. And if you read the 17 goals, and if you have followed the work that has been put into arriving at that point, you'll see that it's actually the manifesto of a planetary consciousness coming together with the endorsement of 193 heads of states and a critical mass of people on a planetary scale. And it's that, I'll just round up by saying it's less than you think. You may be scared about what's happening now politically when you look to America, to the United States, and in Europe, and there's a majority somehow, or close to a majority of people who want to step back and defend everything and act based on fear, but a critical mass is not that many. I think there's scientific calculations that it's around maybe 10-15%. If we can organize 10-15% of the imaginable minds, the brilliant minds, and work together, we'll be able to turn around the masses. And we've set up a plan for that, which I hope I'll be able to come back to. But just thank you for allowing me to be here and speak. And let's move on to the next speaker. Thank you.